yeah, it was devastating for a lot of us. And like you said, if we didn't win the 14 World Cup, that group of players would have walked out with a monkey on our back, thinking that we never did that. But we were lucky enough to win a World Cup. Each and every time that we lost a World Cup final, we did not know exactly what hit us. But how we gathered our thoughts and how we managed to get together as a group was that we realized that we are a tiny island nation and we are challenging rest of the world. And we've got to 5 World Cup finals within a space of 10 years. So obviously the processes, the structures, the methods that we're thinking is correct. We don't have to do too many changes, but we just need to believe in ourselves when it comes to it's the end of the day, it's a sport and reaction to situations. And 4 years of hard work comes down to one day or a one session or could be a one over, and that makes a difference. So we needed to simplify and say we just need to go and enjoy those finals a bit better. We need to back ourselves and express ourselves and be proud that, you know, we are representing our country and enjoy, because it took us 5 World Cups but we won one as a group. But the consistency that we showed as a group was the most important thing, that we stuck to the values that we believed in that dressing room, and we worked hard, and we probably was the most consistent team in that decade. So that was something that we were very proud of, and that's something that, yes, we've lost 4 World Cups, but that processes, that work ethic, that understanding that we had in that group is something that we cannot forget, and no one can take away from that, you know, no one can take that away from us. So that's how we regrouped, and that's how we believed in ourselves and believed in our ability, and we managed to push that last World Cup and win that. So that was a brilliant feeling, and yes, we definitely celebrated that afterwards.